Right, got my trusty guitar on my back. The last few months I've been working on a special musical collaboration related to a very important number in nature. We're about to head off down the road to meet this collaborator for the very first time, and I'm very excited about it. We're at the studio of Mr. Dave Brown here, who's a very yes, with his trademark high, who's a very talented musician, producer. So we're writing a song, a math metal song about phi. Math metal's a genre which has very sort of mathematically based riffs, I guess, very, very syncopated, very technical. And after we filmed a video on phi for Numberphile a few months ago, Dave got in touch and was keen to collaborate and to really take that idea and push it further. And so what we've done is we've based a song around the number phi, based the rhythms, based the melody, if you can call it that, based the lyrics all around phi, the number phi.
First riff I've got in the song, this nice clean one. Before we punch you in the face. And that's derived from a riff Phil came up with, as you can see here, quite conveniently, from the different digits of phi.
What we also want to do, as well as mapping the digits of phi onto the melodies, onto the riffs, and onto the rhythms, is also somehow embed the geometry of phi in the song. And the way we're going to do that is we're going to take the guitar string, length of the guitar string, and we're going to pick out the note which defines, so the position on the string, which defines the golden ratio, the note of the golden ratio, as it were. And so what we're doing is we have, this is a guitar string from here to here. The fundamental definition of the golden ratio is you've got A, B. So you've got a length A and you've got a length B here. So A plus B over A is equal to A over B, and that's equal to phi. What we're going to do now is use your wonderful golden ratio calipers, wherever they've gone, to define where that note is. It's going to be a note that's not going to match up exactly with where, though it's not too far off, where we have a fret on the guitar. It's just slightly below the 17th fret. And then what we're going to do is we're going to overdub on top of that, or maybe build it up, we'll see. As Dave suggested, what we're going to do is then build this up. So we'll go from that just below the 17th fret, then we're going to choose another note, which as you can see is just around about where the screws and the pickup are. And then we're going to subdivide that down again, each time building up and each time defining the music of the gold, or the note of the golden ratio geometrically.
Okay, so this next riff, I thought it'd be quite cool if we took the number of chugs that a guitar plays, technical term, a chug is when the guitar goes, sounds kind of like it's onomatopoeic. And we took the number of them and put a gap in between each one. And if you count the number of chugs between each gap, you actually get the number phi, which is quite cool. So take a listen. So there was one chug, six chugs, one chug, eight. Yep, you get the idea.
So these are gold nanoparticles, two nanometers across in water. Vial, we're not going to really use the nanoparticles. What we are going to use is the vial that the nanoparticles are in, but of course it's gold, it's golden ratio, so we thought it was apt. Well, I thought it was apt.
Next up, we get to a riff that's kind of like the pi video that you guys did, where Phil mapped the digits of pi onto a scale. We did that with phi onto the B flat harmonic minor scale. I'm not really good at musical tech, I do it by ear. Can I get you shouting into the mic? I need to get a level, unfortunately. I'll give you some volume so you can do it, but...
Yeah! Real but uncountable!
I haven't done this for a long, long time, over 20 years. So I was in a band while I was a student, while I was a postgraduate as well.
Irrational!
I did A-level maths. I got a C. I blame my teacher. I'm more of a musician now. I have a YouTube channel called Boy in a Band. You can search for that. It'll probably be in the description. I'll make sure Brady puts it there.
I will even put it. It'll be just on the. There
we go. How about that?
Cool.
But yes, I make music of varying styles. Lots of electronic music, but I'm horrendously into metal as well. I've just used horrendously twice. I hope that's okay.
And that's from the equation! Spirals out of control!
1 6 1 8 0 3 3 9 8 8 7 4. It's been a hell of a lot of fun, and I'm really happy with the song. I think we've done some very interesting things. We've gone beyond, you know, people talk about math metal, but math metal, those riffs sound complicated, but they're not really mapped onto maths. In this case, we've actually gone beyond that, and there's only one other band, to the best of my knowledge, that has attempted anything like this before, and that's a band called After the Burial.
The proportion is divine.
So phi is 1 plus the square root of 5 over 2, so we decided to be a bit clever, and we have got 1 in this by the open string on the guitar representing that, and the other notes being played by the guitar are the digits of square root 5, and then over 2 we go into half-time drums partway through this, which we thought was quite clever, so...
Quite clever, isn't it?
Yeah!
You're pleased with it?
Yeah.
Some people might not consider it beautiful. I think the way that the mats are embedded throughout the song, yeah, has its own bizarre beauty about it, yes.
And we do a similar thing for the outro as well. The one there is that boom, top note. Then we've got the chugs, you know what chugs are, doing square root of 5, and again, half-time drums.
Leibniz was a very famous mathematician, developed calculus independently of Newton, and he has this wonderful quote, which is that music is the human mind counting when it doesn't know that it's counting. And that's great. There are these fundamental links between numbers, between maths, between music. And it's great to actually embed those so tightly as we do in doing this song.
Well, hopefully by now you're all dying to hear the finished song. I know I am. I haven't actually got the final copy from Dave yet. We're going to upload it here on the Numberphile channel on Friday. If you're watching this video after Friday, I'll have the link below the video and you'll be able to find it, of course. Also below the video in the description, I'll have a link to Dave's channel. You really should check it out. He's a super talented guy. And I'll also have some information under the video about these golden mean calipers, which were sent to us from New Zealand. They're lots of fun, and I'm sure you're all going to have some questions about them. And we'll be using them in some future videos we've got coming about the golden ratio on Numberphile in the weeks and months to come. But for now, we'll hear the song on Friday.